From the choice of landing location to a brand new way of exploring, today we look at what NASA's Perseverance rover will do on Mars. Evening the score. Mars 29, Earth 28. To date, human beings have sent 61 missions to Mars. Four are currently en route, namely the United Arab Emirates Mars mission and the Chinese Tianwen-1 orbiter and the Tianwen-1 lander rover. And now, of course, the Mars 2020, carrying the NASA Perseverance rover, which is officially launched and on its way as of July 30, 2020. 29 of these earlier missions were claimed by the Red Planet or lost before they could return any data. Getting to Mars is hard. On the other occasions, current ones included, humanity has succeeded 28 times in our quests to visit the planet named after the Roman god of war, Mars. What happens to the four currently in transit remains to be seen. Why are we so fascinated with this probe-destroying planet? Well, when you're looking at greater than a 50% failure rate, it becomes much more of a challenge. For another thing, it is not nearly as hostile as our closest approaching neighbor, Venus, whose surface, which is 464 degrees Celsius or 867 degrees Fahrenheit, well past the point of molten lead. We've had even less success landing there. So, despite the inherent difficulty, Mars is easier. Assuming we make it. Hopefully on February 18, 2021, this mission will touch down in Jezero Crater. Why Jezero? It is a site that appears to have been covered in water billions of years ago for a protected period of time, sufficient for life to have had a chance to develop or migrate there. In other words, this is a good spot to study Mars's ancient hydrology and its soil chemistry. If you look at this image, you can see that the area looks very much like the roots of a tree. This dendritic pattern, which is highly reminiscent of the Mississippi River Delta, was made over the course of thousands and thousands of years as sediment built up and water carved its way through. This pattern shows that the water flowed for an extended time, to create the delta in the first place, but then kept flowing until the crater filled. How is Perseverance different than Curiosity? Actually, they are surprisingly similar. There is some new and better instrumentation, but on the whole, it is the same machine. They are the same size, being 2.7 meters long and 2.9 meters wide, making a very stable platform for negotiating rough terrain, and equally tall at 2.1 meters. If you look at these side-by-side images of both, you probably could not tell which one is which. And that applies even if you're relatively familiar with either or both of them. Perseverance is on the right. Why so similar? Ask yourself. If Curiosity was designed for a 90-day mission and was still running 14 years later, do you really want to change anything regarding the fundamental operations base of the machine? The answer is obviously no. If it works, don't fix it. Now, one part that really did not work well was Curiosity's wheels. Images showed large chunks missing as the mission progressed. Since everything had to travel by very expensive rocket, mission cost $2.47 billion, it was made as light as possible. This time, Perseverance wheels are a lot hardier. In addition, they've been designed to resist getting stuck in the soft soil that trapped Spirit permanently, ending its mobile mission, and which also trapped Opportunity on several occasions while engineers figured out how to extricate it. What will Perseverance do? Imagine how much your telephone has improved in the last 10 years. Just a single decade of technological advancement has improved your phone in manifold ways. That happens in the space industry too. And in fact, the space industry itself is often responsible for these technological leaps that you enjoy. Pictures. First off, is the imagery that we'll be getting back. Curiosity had a 2-megapixel camera. Great for the time it was built. Perseverance will sport a 20-megapixel camera for that just like being there feeling. And just to make sure nothing happens to it, we're actually getting 23 cameras in total. So we can study materials close up and unimaginable detail. And not just is visible light. So that should be quite informative. Sounds. It's also going to have microphones for the first time. Imagine overlooking that on previous missions. A microphone could be extremely high fidelity back in the Curiosity days for a few grams, plus some circuitry to digitize it and connect to the radio rigs, yet it was regarded as unnecessary. Well, they're now so small and lightweight that we're getting two microphones this time. One will record the sounds of the ship as it makes its entry through the atmosphere. The other will be an ambient noise microphone that records sounds from around the rover as it works, moves, or observes. What will another planet sound like? With only 1% the density of Earth's atmosphere, it may be thin and reedy, but with the technology we have here on Earth, we can process that sound to make it match what it would sound like in our atmosphere. That could be useful to help us identify noises. Rocks and clays and carbonates. Oh my! This area where Perseverance is landing will have water-related chemicals galore, so we really ought to learn a great deal concerning its hydrological history. Even though NASA makes no particular claims regarding the existence of past life on Mars, this looks like a premier spot to find some evidence of that life, if it ever existed. There's almost certain to be sedimentation all along the former waterways. We'll be able to look at the discrete layers as they were laid it down over the centuries, and in between those layers may be microfossils of extinct creatures. To aid in that, Perseverance is equipped with a new and improved drilling rig, with better, more sensitive drills, hammers, and grinders. Curiosity had difficulty with some samples that would simply crumble when the drill made contact. Perseverance has a lot more finesse, especially since it will be dealing with a lot of clays, which are intrinsically soft, keeping it clean. Interestingly, a new module had been added which will collect samples. Perseverance isn't coming back to Earth, so why collect them? Well, NASA wants pristine samples before any humans get to Mars, so the materials collected will be pure Martian samples. They're even going so far as to include special sampling tubes that will be opened while the sampling process is going on. Nothing will go in these tubes other than whatever is floating in the air near the rover during the collection. If there is any sort of outgassing from the rover itself, or some sort of biological material that was transferred from Earth, these witness tubes will have something to compare the original samples to, so we will know if we accidentally contaminated them ourselves. How can we get the samples back? That's where it gets interesting. NASA is going to decide what to do with the tubes. It may cache them all in a series of locations along Perseverance's route, or it may decide to drop them all in an easily accessible spot. Whichever they decide, another mission sometime in the late 2020s will probably be sent with a lightweight mini rover that's capable of picking up the samples and delivering them to a launching system that can fire them back into Mars orbit. They'll then rendezvous with an equally small Earth return vehicle, probably powered by twin ion engines, and return home for a ballistic hard landing and retrieval. However, since nothing is set in stone, there also exists the possibility that some independent company, like SpaceX, might land somewhere in the vicinity, simply pick them up, and bring them back manually. As long as they can be kept sterile, the methodology of their return doesn't really matter. Getting where it needs to go. The coolest part of the whole mission for the casual observer is that the Mars 2020 mission is going to include the very first drone carried to another planet for the sole purpose of flying around in its atmosphere. Now, of course, the scientists will be using this drone, named Ingenuity, to survey the local geography to plot the best course for Perseverance to navigate to areas of interest with minimal obstacles. The difficulty is that the drone will have to work very hard to fly in such a thin atmosphere. It will use two counter-rotating stacked props to control flight direction, altitude, speed, and every other function so as to maximize mechanics and hence weight. Even so, it will only be able to fly for approximately 3 minutes per flight. It's scheduled for 5 flights during the mission, but if all goes well, there will probably be several more. It is capable of much higher resolution photos than from an orbiting satellite. Making oxygen. Another important aspect of the mission is the MOXIE experiment. This will attempt to make oxygen from Mars's atmosphere. As we discussed in our video on SpaceX's plan on Mars, SpaceX intends to mine water ice from the surface and use electrolysis to create the oxygen they need, while using the hydrogen to blend with CO2 from air to make methane fuel. NASA's plan differs in that they intend to make oxygen directly from CO2, which is 96% of the Martian atmosphere. Science is all about trying different methodologies to find out which works best. The takeaway. Perseverance will explore that crater in detail to draw a really sophisticated and complete image of the area. It may end up answering a lot of questions regarding whether the planet ever had life of its own. If our solar system was subject to panspermia, all life in our solar system may be similarly based on DNA that formed off-planet and simply landed here. If Martian life is significantly different than life here, we will have evidence that different forms of life can evolve under different conditions. This makes it much more likely that there is other life in the universe. That is a pretty big question to answer, and puts us on the path to answering the biggest question of them all. Are we alone? Do you think there was ever life on Mars? Let us know in the comments below, and then check out this next video that you might find interesting.